Hello guys, Furball the Hammy, your friendly neighborhood hamster, is back again for another Hypixel Skyblock video. And in today's video, we will be discussing about the best mage gear and cheaper alternative options for mage on your path to becoming a good mage in dungeons. However, before we begin, be sure to subscribe to the channel because we are closing in on YouTube rank at 30,000 subscribers, and I have placed 4 challenges down for you guys at 4 different subscriber goals. At 22.5k, I will be doing 2,000 tier 3 tarantulas. At 25,000, I will be doing 1,000 tier 4 revs cause I hate revs and you guys force me to do it. At 27.5k, I will be doing 200 floor 5s or the latest dungeon floor 200 times. At 30,000 subscribers, I will be doing the ultimate challenge of grinding until I get every single RNG drop for slayers in the entire game. So yeah, feel free to subscribe if you want to see me die of carpal tunnel syndrome. And without further ado, let's begin the video. Firstly, I will be splitting up the categories into 3 sections. Firstly, for players under Catacombs 9, secondly, for most of the players between Catacombs 9 to 24, and the last category being players who are Catacombs level 25 and above. However, be sure to note that I'm not the most qualified to be talking about this because I am only Catacombs 25 and Mage 25, but I haven't done a single XP run, so I do have quite a bit of experience regarding dungeons. So first and foremost, for those under Catacombs 9, there really aren't any amazing sets for you to use as a mage. My only suggestion for you is to use a Bonzo Staff and a Frozen Scythe or an Epic Dreadlord Sword for those who are tight on the budget. Preferably, you want a low mana and a powerhouse mage weapon together, along with a Voodoo Doll. The low mana option can be the Frozen Scythe or the Epic Dreadlord Sword, and the powerhouse mage weapons, the examples of those are Bonzo Staff, Spirit Scepter, and the Yeti Sword. You can use the old regular Necrotic Wise Dragon Armor with Loving Chestplate until you are Catacombs 9 and grind Floor 2s or Floor 1s with it. You can also use it with the Bonzo Mask if you are dying a lot, since it only requires Floor 1 completion and doesn't have any Catacombs requirements. If you are rich and intend to get started on dungeons and want to start doing Floor 4s out of the gate, you could buy Adaptive Armor and ask someone to carry you through Floor 3 just once, since that's the only requirement, but I wouldn't recommend it because all of the mage gear used later on does not require Adaptive at all and are all cheaper than Adaptive Armor itself. Next up, for Catacombs 9 to 24. You have more options which are good in this area, and the gear used here can clear Floor 4 easily and even S+ F5 with a good team. At Catacombs 9, you get access to the legendary Zombie Soldier armor. You can use the legendary version and I strongly recommend it. The setup for Catacombs 9 is Dark Goggles, legendary Zombie Soldier chestplate and leggings, and with the Spirit Boots. You can ask anyone to carry you through Floor 4 once just to use the Spirit Boots because that is the only requirement. For cheaper options, you can use the legendary Zombie Soldier Boots, which is 300,000 coins in comparison to Spirit Boots, which costs 5 mil. In fact, I didn't even use Spirit Boots until I was Catacombs 23. You can also consider using a Bonzo Mask if you are having trouble staying alive in dungeons and want more survivability. If you are in a pinch, you can buy the high quality epic versions of Zombie Soldier instead of the legendary versions, preferably those with 40 plus or higher in terms of quality. If you don't understand what I mean by quality, with this SBE mod, Skyblock Extras mod, it tells me what quality an item is, and if an item has a 50 upon 50 quality, it becomes a legendary item. You can probably snag a 45 upon 50 quality Zombie Soldier armor piece for less than 300k for all 3 pieces, which is cheaper than the legendary versions, which cost between 1.5 to 2.5 mil. Next up, at Catacombs 15, you unlock access to super heavy armor. Now, if you are still having trouble surviving Floor 4 or Floor 5 at this stage, you can consider using super heavy chestplate and leggings and play the role of a tank mage fusion class. However, it is not necessary to use this armor and it is entirely up to a personal preference. If you prefer being a tankier mage, then sure, consider it. Next up, at Catacombs 16, you get access to Shadow Goggles, which can be bought from the NPC at a Dungeons Hub, instead of Dark Goggles, and I do strongly recommend it. You can still continue using the Bonzo Mask, although at Catacombs 16, you shouldn't be dying really often unless you are doing Floor 5. So yeah, at Catacombs 16, I do recommend the Shadow Goggles over the Bonzo Mask. and that's really about it for armor. For weapons, I strongly recommend using the Spirit Scepter or the Yeti Sword. Now hear me out, I know the Yeti Sword does more damage, and I did use the Yeti Sword for like 10 runs to test it because someone loaned me the Yeti Sword, but the Scepter is 2.5 times cheaper and I still use it in floor 5s a day, and I am capable of getting S plus floor 5s in 7 minutes or less consistently with just Scepter and the Frozen Scythe, nothing really fancy. I also felt that the Yeti was harder to use because of the cooldown and attack animation, which forced you to aim at where you think the mob will be in the next 1 to 1.5 seconds instead of aiming at the mob itself. Because as you can see here, the attack animation of lifting up and throwing the rock in combination with the cooldown of the Yeti sword makes it harder to aim than the Scepter, which is really instant and basically when you right click it, the bat instantly comes out and can kill something. However, if you like the Yeti sword or are good with it, feel free to use it as it can be better under Catacombs 28 if you do know how to use it. But in general, I find the Scepter a much more cheaper option and a much more easier to use option. So yeah, I do recommend the Spirit Scepter or a Yeti with the Frozen Scythe for low and high mana options. I personally do recommend you to have a Frozen Scythe, but even without it, it's still possible to do floor 5s with it. It's just that I personally enjoy using the Frozen Scythe against mini bosses, so then I can slow them down without consuming much mana. But yeah, I wouldn't say it is a necessity to get a Frozen Scythe, but it is a good choice to have, and it is really cheap as compared to other options like Ice Spray Wand and the Yeti Sword. And yeah, also don't forget the Voodoo Doll for single target side damage. You can consider buying the Ice Spray Wand, which you get access to at Catacombs 20 if you are rich. It is good, but not necessary. And last but not least, for players who are above Catacombs 25, there aren't really new weapons for you here. The weapons are the same old Ice Spray Wand, Yeti Sword, Frozen Scythe, Spirit Scepter, and basically just the same old mage weapons. However, you do get access to different types of armor sets, which you can use and consider. At Catacombs 25, I recommend using 5-star Young Dragon armor to replace the zombie soldier armor. Not necessary, but the extra speed and EHP does make it pretty nice. At Catacombs 28, I strongly recommend 5-star Wise Dragon armor because it is by far the best mage armor that you can use. You can consider using 3/4 Wise with Shadow Goggles or full Wise without any goggles. Yeti is also not a bad choice at this point because at Catacombs 28, you can dungeonize your Yeti sword, which will make it much more better than a Spirit Scepter. But that's really about it, and a dungeon a day keeps a slash G-Kit command away, so be sure to do your daily dungeons, and this is Furball the Hammy, your Slayer and Dungeon Maniac, signing out.